Scott, everybody is really excited about machine learning. You pointed out that we are at the peak at Gartner hype cycle right now, but it's difficult to implement. I'd like you to discuss a little bit this excitement and the difficulty on implementing machine learning.
Yeah, there's a tremendous amount of excitement right now with respect to machine learning. And part of that's because we see it in so many different applications across our lives. And there's been a broad acceptance of the fact that this technology is the only way that we can go leverage all the data that's collected about us and our activities. So there's a lot of excitement and a lot of promise. The challenge, though, is that excitement is not met with the types of talent that can actually build models that are responsible, meaning that we can go build a machine learning model, but we may not understand all the ramifications of how that model will respond and the assumptions that have gone into building this model. And that's one of the big challenges, because if we're going to trust a model and we're going to make the decisions based on these models, we need to deeply understand how they're built, and we need to make sure the people that are building them are taking the right steps to build them properly.
And one big issue is bias. Why is that, and how to avoid bias, making sure there is no discrimination on these models and, of course, on the results coming out of these models?
Yeah, so bias is, you know, the machine learning model, when it runs, is simply trying to optimize an outcome. Let's say a prediction of who might be delinquent or who may not be delinquent. And so it'll find the most optimal way to do that and use whatever information it can use. The challenge is that we need to specifically build the model and test the model to make sure that it's not learning relationships that might bias one group versus another group. And so this is a situation where a naive data scientist would just build the model, right? But when we build a model to make sure it's not biased, we cannot do just the simple things. The simple things would be to remove things like race or gender or sexual preference. But there are other factors in terms of their behavior that might help predict what race they are, what gender they are. And so we have to control for that and then do tests of whether or not those subgroups are getting a disproportionate negative outcome based on this machine learning model. And if they are, go back to that feature or that variable, remove it, and rebuild.
Is this a role or something that only vendors should be preoccupied about, or is also a duty from companies that use those models?
So everyone who develops a machine learning model needs to be thinking about this. Vendors very often are working on it because their customers have asked them to remove bias or to make sure the models are not biased. But I think it's the responsibility of every single data scientist and any business that uses a machine learning model to have a program and a practice around making sure that these models are built in such a way that they can be auditable and they can demonstrate that there is no bias in place. Vendors are more than happy to help with, you know, providing software and technology to do that, but simply not doing that or not paying attention to that in machine learning is just not acceptable in today's day.
Talking about the data protections law that come out in Europe, and we have here also in Brazil, how do then change machine learning and intelligence and artificial intelligence?
So the regulations that have come up, like GDPR and others across the globe, are tremendously important. And they're actually combating a lot of this excitement around machine learning, because it basically states that we have to use and develop these models such that they are fair. So as an example, right, GDPR says that I have to be able to explain how the model came to its decision, and just explain it in a way that a human being will understand it, which now means that people are starting to look much more carefully at how they build these models to demonstrate that they can explain in each and every decision. And this is where the science of explainable AI has taken hold, where we are developing ways to explain models, or in fact, maybe coming up with entirely different models that are explainable, because we have to meet the regulatory concerns. So I think it's a great thing, because it's bringing a lot of maturity and responsibility back into the use of machine learning models. But in the same tone, right, many different organizations lack experience in explainable AI methods, and so it'll take a little time to get there, but the regulation is setting a standard of conduct and how we use machine learning models, which is incredibly important before we become too dependent upon their decisions.
Do they limit in any way the use of data?
So very often these regulations will specify that you have to have the rights in place to use that data. So for example, if you build a model, you have to make sure that I have the right to use that, and very often it's the customers have given permission to use this data. If you're using data that has not gone through this data provenance, where you've demonstrated that you have the ability to use the data, right, you could invalidate that model. And so that's the other major component here, is to make sure that the data that we're using, we know where it came from, we know that we have the rights to use that data in a model, and if we don't, to not use it.
Do companies need to reveal legacies in order to be in compliance for these data privacy regulations?
So organizations need to make sure that they can go show the provenance of where data came from. Very often it's going to be a legal agreement that in between where they got that data and say what are they using within that data. Very often regulators will want to understand specifically what data elements within some of these data sources are being used, because some of those may be more sensitive or less sensitive from a regulatory perspective. And so there is a lot more scrutiny around what are the data sources, do we have the rights to use them, and then what are the specific data elements that are we using as part of those data feeds.